I got beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, rams,
corn,
beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit.
You name it.
Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, rams, corn, beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys, beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes.
Worst type of people at Thanksgiving. We've all had that one day where something might have went wrong or someone had to ruin it and it just so happened to be a holiday. Whether it was New Year's, Valentine's Day, Halloween, or Christmas. Each year they all ain't gonna be perfect. But probably one of the most problematic holidays is Thanksgiving. Boy, don't get me wrong though, boy, I love to eat. But when you got a bunch of food and a whole family, it's just bound to cause problems. And y'all probably had your own experiences on Thanksgiving, but just know these is mine. So some of y'all probably gonna relate and some of y'all probably ain't. So I don't hear nobody talking about, so that never happened on my Thanksgiving. Like, nigga, I'm not talking about you. But yeah, let's get into our first one. So first one we got is the speech givers.
This school system. Then why did you stay in Mexico?
You need to leave.
But no, hear me out. Look, I don't know what it is about when there's food involved, but niggas want to turn to Martin Luther King and start giving these long-ass speeches. And I don't mean like 2 to 3, 5 minutes. I'm talking about like 15 to 20 minutes. Like, twin, the food ain't getting no hotter, bro. I understand some Thanksgiving, you know, you go around, you ask everybody what they thankful for, and then, you know, they say God or like food or like having me over here. But I remember one time when I was at this Thanksgiving party, and I don't really know how old I was at the time, probably like 6 or 7. You know, we was going around just asking everybody what they grateful for, and then it stopped on this one dude. And when I tell you, this nigga didn't talk for 20 minutes. Like, everybody else is like 5 to 10 seconds. Everybody, you know, just, they might just say one thing, but this dude was just yapping. And it got to the point where I kind of was just getting annoyed, and I just kind of did like a light sigh. I was like, and then my grandma gave me that look, in which if you black, you probably know what I'm talking about. Yeah, the one that means that you probably about to get an ass whoop if you don't pipe down. But we got food in the bag, and by the time this dude got done talking, the food was all like all warm and just room temperature. I even took a picture of the food so y'all can see what I had, but that shit was good. So if this ever happens to you, just go get up and get you a plate. The ass beating is worth it. All right, next up we got the food rationers. There's no better way to describe these people than just straight selfish. You might be one of them. You greedy bitch. Cause like, why are you taking all the food? And the worst thing about these people is they always spawn out of nowhere when there's food around. Like, you don't ever see them on any other day besides like Labor Day or Thanksgiving or like some other shit. But when they do pull up, they start taking up all the food. I'm saying like 5 scoops of everything. Like one time I was waiting in line and this dude in front of me got like 5 to 6 big scoops of mac and cheese. Dude got 1/4 of the whole tray. Like, bro, what are you doing? Then I look up at his plate and this nigga motherfucker got like a whole Mount Everest of food, like mashed potatoes, mac and cheese, everything. But I'm like, damn, you fat fuck. I hope you plan on feeding kids in Africa with that shit. This remind me of another time, kind of unrelated, but I went up to go get a piece of pie and somebody done cut at the edge of the sweet potato pie and just left the crust. I don't know whose side of the family that was, but whoever that was, that nigga wicked on me. Next up, we got the orangutan kids. I can guarantee you that there's always gonna be kids at the Thanksgiving function, and they always gonna be annoying as hell. But not all of them. Some of them be chill. Like, I'm talking about the ones that be jumping up and down on the couches and never get ass beaten by their parents. For example, I was on the couch eating my mac and cheese and minding my own damn business. Then this one little nigga walks up to me, and I can tell he in a playful mood because he over here look like he got done playing recess. And I'm just looking at him like, bro, like, yeah, can I help you? Then he tells me to close my eyes for some reason, and that right there is where I fucked up. So I'm sitting there like, why you want me to close my eyes? But I was like, if he'll make you go away, I'm like, all right. So I closed my eyes for about a good like 3 seconds and then I opened them up. Y'all would not guess what this nigga done did. I looked down and this nigga got his little grummy booger eating ass hands all over my plate. You can only imagine what I did to him, but I had to put the beats to his ass. I mean, shit, am I wrong though? Like, shit, he put his whole hand on my plate. Now I gotta get up and get me a second one. So after I smacked the shit out of him, he goes off telling his parents and they wind up coming to me talking about some, oh, if you got a problem, my kid, come to me. Dude. In my head, I'm just sitting there like, nigga, if you don't shut your ass up, cause let me sit there and spit in my hand, wipe my ass and put my hand all over your food and see if you going to my mom for it. Which I don't think nobody going for, but hey, that's just me personally. So if you ever got orangutan kids at your party, don't ever let them test your power level. Then they might go ahead and put a handful of cooties and dookie particles in your potato salad. But that being said, let's go to our next one. All right, this time we got the family clouders. And you're probably sitting there like, what is that? What is the family clouders? What does that even mean? And that's why I have my Twizzy Willy, so I'm gonna pass it to him.
Yes, that'll be me. Thank you, partner. Family clout is a phenomenon where relatives downplay your character or achievements for their own social status. An example of this would be someone calling you out for not having a job and cracking jokes at it to make the family laugh. The theory suggests it thrives on proximity to ego combined with inflated sense of entitlement. Hey, what the? Are you sleeping? Wake up! Jesus. Back to what I was saying, there's 2 ways to avoid this situation. Option A, set boundaries and redirect conversations to neutral topics. Or option B, assert dominance by roasting the absolute shit out of your opposition to backfire and reverse their attack. Thank you for listening to the lesson with your boy Science Willy, aka Nonchalant Subconscious Mind. And remember, stay cool. Back to you, Shalant.
Yeah, thanks. Boy, that a good nerd. Wait, that's me. Because when you got some family members that like to crack jokes at you just for your expense, just because they want some family clout, it gets personal. And of course, you already know I got a story for this one, too. So it's Thanksgiving and everybody kind of like chopping it up in the living room and shit. And at some point, it kind of turned to like a family minor roast off. I don't know how, but it just did. But so everybody laughing, this old head dude and this one other relative is kind of like going back and forth. And I'm like 8 or 9, so I'm like in the front, kind of like trying to see what's going on, whatever. Everybody laughing, and the old dude just start kind of picking people off. Then he kind of like turns my way and looks at me. He's like, he hits me with the, "Oh, I know you ain't laughing." I'm sitting there like, "Bro, what? Nigga, I don't even know who you is." Keep in mind, majority of these family members, I don't really have no memory of, because I don't really never see them that much. So this nigga done brought me into the battle talking about some, "Oh, you little chubby thing, ain't you?" Oh yeah, for the record, I used to be chubby, by the way. Like Phantom. Okay, maybe not that big, but I was chubby. And he's saying some other shit, talking about some like, "Oh, he used to cry a lot, he used to get what he want, this and that." I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, you got dementia? Like, what is you saying? So it kind of got to the point where I kind of just started roasting him back. And this is before my training art. So like I said, I was like 8 or 9. So my roasts weren't really perfected yet. And little did he know, he didn't know I was going to start roasting him back. And I started saying he had a bald spot on his head. He got cinder block feet. He got bad bones, aka arthritis. Everybody looking at me like, "Damn, bro, too far." I'm like, "Bro, y'all niggas lame, bro." I was like, "Y'all niggas lame." If that doesn't establish the idea of the family clout theory, I don't know what does. Okay, last but not least, we got the leftover gladiators. And ain't really much that goes into this, but really just a bunch of niggas that be acting like they don't know how to make a plate and then try to take yours. Like, that's what we doing? We out here stealing food now? Like, I swear, bro, it be your own people. And one last story before we end the video. So everybody got done, you know, eating their food or whatever on some shit, and basically everybody's packing up their food. And I packed mine up and I left mine on the table. And boy, was I stupid. So I done went to the bathroom and came back and my plate was gone. I'm out here trying to look for the corporate, and I asked my mom, like, did you get my plate? She's like, "Nah, I didn't get your plate," which I wasn't surprised. I'm out here looking for it, and I come across to see it with my second cousin. I go walk up to him. I'm like, "Yo, is that my plate?" This nigga hit me with the, "Oh, I didn't know it was yours. My bad, little man." I'm like, "Mm-hmm, sure." I'm like, "Bro, if I didn't just come up here, you probably would have just stole my plate. Like, I know you didn't just get exactly all the food that I got." So he gave me back my plate, and I want to go sit down and wash it over until like 10 minutes before after we left. But truth of the matter is don't be stealing niggas' food. Nobody likes that. I hope y'all enjoyed today's video. It was a little late, but I mean, shit, what can you do? Right, nothing, because you ain't gonna do shit. But happy Thanksgiving to everybody. I appreciate all the love and support y'all been showing on my channel. Yes, I'm very grateful. Comment down something below you grateful for. And be sure to join Discord, link down in the description. All right, but I'm gonna catch y'all in the next video. All right, peace out.